All right. So, bunch the board, you or the children or all of it?
A little bit of everything.
Okay.
However you wanna.
This is Ashlee.
Okay.
Look at the computer.
What am I looking at?
The colors.
Oh, yeah. We'll talk about that, why I picked those colors in a little bit.
Okay, remember, we're being listeners.
I'll have plenty of time for you to ask questions at the end if you have some after we're all done, okay? All right, so does anybody remember what the question I just asked was? No.
What's culture?
What is culture? Does anybody know what culture is?
No.
Ava does.
What do you think it is, Ava?
I think it's where all around the world where people live.
Well, that's kind of what it is, Elf.
Where you live and what is your personality?
Let's go. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about it, but I'm gonna tell you what the definition is. Do you know what definitions are? Yeah. Okay. So this is according to the British anthropologist, and his name was Sir Edward Burnett Tylor, and he said culture is that complex whole which individuals' knowledge, belief, arts, their morals, law, customs, and any other capabilities and habits that are acquired by a person that's a member of society. So it's the things in society that you do, that you act, that you say, maybe things you eat, different things like that. And sometimes, a lot of times, when it comes to people or cultures, people have what are called stereotypes. Does anybody know what stereotypes are?
No, I don't.
Well, a really basic way to know what stereotypes is kind of what you think of somebody. They're things that we assume about a big group of people based on what we know about one person. So, if I were to ask anybody here from watching Frozen or anything else, Ella, you said you're Norwegian. Does anybody have anything that they think that they would know about Norway or might know about Norway?
Oh, it's Ava.
Ella?
They
do eat lefse. Ava?
They talk Norwegian.
They do talk Norwegian. Anybody else?
Norwegian.
One more, Ava?
They have beautiful colors.
Well, let's get started. And first, what we're going to do is we're going to read this book. It's called In the Hall of the Mountain King. And this book is about, that takes place in Norway. Then after we finish this book, we're going to do a little PowerPoint to teach you a little bit more about Norway and ask some questions about Norway that are based on this book. So the thing that I'm going to tell you about this book is pay really close attention to the pictures, because at the end when I ask some questions, they might relate to some of these pictures or some of the things that happen in the story. Alright, so, it says, in the country of Norway, a boy named Per lived on the forest edge where the trees and mountains are tall. His little house faced west so he could always see the sea. When the sun was out and the smell of adventure was in the air, Per loved to go exploring. He always found treasure, rocks and were round and sparkly, lizards that were brown and bumpy, and trees with branches spaced just right for a boy to climb. One day, Per ventured through the forest out to the other side, farther than he had ever been before. There he found the best treasure of all, a castle. People had often told stories of a mysterious mountain king who lived beyond the forest. Maybe this was his castle. Per couldn't wait to find out, so he slipped through the front gate. At first, he tiptoed along, careful not to make a sound, his eyes wide at the wonders before him. The stories were true. He saw the mountain king's riches with his own eyes. From passage to passage and room to room, Per grew more confident. Maybe he could be the king. He walked and marched and skipped and spun on the marble floors, wishing the day would never end. Per rounded a corner, and who did he bump into? but the Mountain King himself. Pierre had been so enchanted that he had forgotten one important thing. He was an uninvited guest. Fear of the Mountain King's fury seized Pierre. Fear of dark dungeons, fear of never again seeing his little house by the sea. The Mountain King bounded after him, but Pierre was faster. As Pierre raced through the castle, he slammed doors behind him, hoping to slow the Mountain King just enough to escape. They ran and ran, doors slammed and slammed. Each door brought Pierre one more step closer to freedom, but the Mountain King was getting nearer and nearer. One last door stood before Pierre, one final door, and he was free. He slid through that door. Slam! Pierre didn't look back as the castle disappeared into the forest beyond the mountain. As he found his way back home, he made a promise. From this day on, he would have his adventures closer to home. At least for a while. All right. So Pierre and his adventure, he was in Norway. So, we're going to talk a little bit about Norway. So, somebody said, where is Norway? Well, Pierre lives in Norway, and Norway is a part of Northern Europe called Scandinavia. According to... according to George D. Hubbard, who wrote an article called The Geography of Residence in Norway Fjord Area, the most population densities, so the most people live on there, when we're looking down the northern, around what is called Oslo. And Oslo is the capital of Norway. Ella, you might have you heard of that theme? No? You haven't heard that one?
I just saw it.
Yes, Ava?
Who's Pierre?
Pierre was the boy in the book.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
I thought you said Peter.
And almost half the people that live in that whole country live in that area by Oslo.
Wait. Pierre is a real person?
And long ago, no, they're just talking, this is relating to the story. So long ago, Scandinavia was home to the Vikings. Who knows what the Vikings are?
Me.
Have you talked about the Vikings?
No.
No, you just know about them? You know about the Vikings?
Uh-huh.
Yeah? So, according to a Norway travel website, where people can look when they're going to travel to Norway and site, they said the Vikings are known as pirates, which I didn't know that until I started reading this. You knew that? And they said that they came to plunder and kill, and they spread terror along Europe's coast. They scared people. But this reputation that they have isn't entirely the truth. They were actually really skilled traders and administrators and craftsmen. So they did lots of things with wood and builders and things like that. Yeah.
My dad likes to do that stuff.
Does he? Lots of dads, like, yeah. In fact, the Vikings actually set up colonies in North America, but today is Canada's eastern province of Newfoundland. Has anybody heard of that in Canada?
North America.
And they did this more than 400 years ago, before Columbus made his voyage across the Atlantic Ocean. I bet you've all talked about Columbus's voyage across the Atlantic Ocean. Heard about that?
No.
No?
No.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. So did somebody in the beginning of this story look like a Viking? Did anybody notice that?
Yeah.
Well, a big person or a little person?
Big.
Yeah, let's look.
Little. It was about Pierre's size.
No. Look at down there, like the little Viking in a boat. So you're going to find out at the end, we're going to talk about some of the other creatures too that might kind of look like that Viking. But they actually have another name for them. So did you need to see it again? Down there in the little boat. Tell by their ears. Sit down.
Can I see?
Yeah, can you see?
Oh,
yeah, right down there in the
little
boat.
That's the little girl Viking.
No, that's not the little girl. See, I thought that at first too, but she's littler. That wasn't the little girl. She's got littler ears. All right, so then there's another picture of Norway. It's more than 1,000 miles long, and it's like 100 miles wide. So it's really long. long and skinny. It's a long, skinny country. And more than half of the border of Norway is all sea. That's pretty cool, huh? And two-thirds of the country, so more than half the country, is covered by mountains. So you know how it can frozen when you see all the mountains?
Elsa goes up one of those mountains.
And in many places, we're going to learn about something. This is called a fjord, where the sea reaches far inland and along the valleys with two steep mountains. So there's two steep mountains on the side and water down in the middle. That's called a fjord. Did we see one of those in the book? Does anybody remember when I said to look closely at the pictures?
Wait.
Do you remember?
That was where the troll was.
Was it at the beginning, the middle, or the end?
The what?
The fjord. That was where, did you see where there was two tall mountains on the side and there was water below?
No.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Was it towards the beginning, middle, or end? Do you think you saw it?
Beginning.
Let's see.
Beginning and end.
Yep.
End.
See what I mean? With the two mountains on the side and then the water below?
Oh.
There's another Viking.
Yeah.
Two Vikings? Yep. There's
one in the front, too. There's mountains in the front, too.
Yeah. Oh, look,
I see little castles.
So then, when we would go back to talking about culture, and how every country and every area has culture. So, we're going to talk about what it's like to live in Norway. Yep, that's the Norwegian flag. So, see how somebody said to me about my colors on my screen in the beginning, how they're blue and red on the background?
Yeah.
That's because those are the Norwegian colors on their flag.
Pink and yellow, white.
Well, that part, the outside, so you can see better on the actual computer.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Were you going to say something, Ella?
Well, I was going up to Minnesota.
Yeah.
And I saw the flag.
Yeah.
On this big mountain.
You go to Minnesota, there's a lot. We have a family cabin. And it says my family's Norwegian and my grandma's all Norwegian, so we have a big sign going into the cabin up in the woods that says, "Welcome to the Norwegian Woods," and then has the last name.
I never noticed that.
So, like somebody said before too, the people of Norway, what are they called?
Norwegians.
And many of the people who live in Norway, they can always see the sea, just like Pierre can see the sea from his house. A lot of people can always see the sea.
Because he lives in Norway.
Yeah. And more than three, so the population of Norway is about 5 million. And almost all, between half and all of those people, live within 10 miles of the coast, of the sea. Isn't that crazy to think?
Yeah.
Think how far we are from the sea. But those people, almost all the people who live in Norway are within 10 miles.
That only takes about
10
an
miles?
Hour?
No. 10 miles oftentimes only takes between 10 and 20 minutes.
Whoa.
Yeah.
So we can drive would be 10 houses.
Now we're going to talk a little bit about something else from the Norwegians' culture.
The
and that is what do Norwegians eat?
Fish.
That's
right.
And then we'll talk about it. So,
fish.
A lot of the times there's something that is called an artifact. You heard of artifacts?
Yeah.
So when you have a cultural artifact, it's anything that is created by somebody that gives information about the culture. So food is an example of an artifact. So the picture that we have right here, anybody know what the fish is that, this is Daniel said we're in the live in Compass, I don't know if anybody heard.
No.
No, well it's a type. It's called lutefisk.
Yeah.
It's not my favorite. I do not like it. But when we are at Christmas, well, I love fish too, but this is not my favorite. When we are at Christmas, and sometimes it's
care.
In a jar and in a can, and my dad and grandpa and everybody, they're always eating this.
Oh,
you'll see Norwegians, this is a staple food for them.
Basket.
And because fishing, because they live so close to the sea, what do you think is a big
fish.
Way for them to get their food?
Fish.
Yeah, fishing is a big part of it because they live so close to the ocean.
I like fish.
And according to the encyclopedia, Norwegians depend, their main things they depend on and always have is their fishing and their farming.
I love fishing!
Do you love fishing?
I've never been fishing, but I want to go.
I've been fishing. There was a book I read,
and the lady's name was Kathleen, and the book was Keeping Christmas, Yuletide Traditions in Norway and New Land. And this was a book that our family has, and it's talks about how lutefisk is, how popular lutefisk is as a Norwegian dish, and it's especially popular around Christmas time. It's a type of, somebody said something about cod. It's a type of dried raw cod.
Oh.
Yeah, and then they soak it.
Yum.
And they salt it.
Yeah.
And it's popular among Norwegians. Even people, a lot of people in America eat this who have Norwegian heritage. But I was nice today and I left the cod. I didn't bring that one. I left that at home. It might stink up the class. So then, what somebody might have seen in my day and what Ella was talking about is lefse.
I love lefse.
Has anybody in this class other than Ava and Ella had lefse?
I don't even know what even
is. I
haven't know what it is. So, it's a soft Norwegian. Well, I'm going to tell. Okay, you say what you think it is.
It's like.
And then you
it's
said
like
Elsa.
It like has a tortilla and then butter and then it has sugar. And
it
it
looks like
up.
A tortilla, you're right. But what it, yeah. It is, it's made out of flour and you use milk or cream and potato. It's a potato. You use potato paint.
Peanut butter and jelly.
And it's cooked on a griddle, like a flat griddle is how you cook it. And it's actually kind of a hard, it's a long process to make. And on my family, I don't know what Ella and your family, do you put sugar on yours?
Yep,
yeah.
We do potatoes too.
Yep.
Potatoes are good on them, but
We always make sure we put sugar on. A lot of people just put butter, especially traditional Norwegians just use butter, but we put sugar on ours to make it a little more
tastier.
Because I wouldn't eat if it didn't have sugar on it.
All right, so now we're going to kind of talk about another thing of culture, is what they like to do.
Skiing.
So, Norway, well first let's talk about how Norway is, they big, like we said, they have lots of mountains, so they and they get snow just like we do here, so they spend a lot of the time in their winter skiing. Yeah, they get a lot of snow. They spend a lot of time in the winter cross-country skiing. Has anybody in here been cross-country skiing?
I want to go skiing.
How about downhill skiing?
Oh, I never even went
skiing.
Or skating on ice.
No. See, we've
been
roller skating. I'm from northern Minnesota where we get a lot of snow, so we've done a lot of that.
Yeah, we've got on
north, I still have snow.
All right, so let's listen to the next part. What do they like to do you think, in the summer? Probably read it up there. They do, because they have these mountains, they do a lot of hiking. They spend a lot of time doing hiking and being outside. Do you think that Pierre seemed like a typical Norwegian, where he was running through and doing? Pierre, do you think he seemed like a person who seemed like the people who live in Norway? After we talked about kind of what they live and do? All right. All right, so this is what is special about Norway's culture. I'm going to read this to you. So the author of this book, Allison Flannery, talks about culture. She says every country has culture, kind of like how we talked about. How people live and what they believe and what their values are is their culture. A culture is formed by a group of people's history, their environment, and their experiences. Every culture includes traditional stories that its people tell, especially to their children. These stories are called narratives. Have you heard of narratives?
Yeah. Have you told me any of your personal narratives?
Narratives are meant to be enjoyed, but they are also meant to teach lessons. These lessons are taught to ensure that those who hear them and are listening learn what is important in their culture and what their culture values. So they find a fun way by teaching narrative to teach these things.
I might hear stories about
All right, so some of Norway's narratives and mythical creatures. Norway's narratives include the adventures of the powerful gods. One is Thor, the ancient Scandinavian god of thunder.
Wait,
so you might have heard of
Thor.
Yeah, but you probably didn't know. And you know what? I didn't even know until I did my research. And then I found a cool book, The Adventures of Thor, the Thunder God. And then they talked about how he is the biggest, strongest, bravest of the gods.
Thor is real.
Thor is history. So Norway's narratives also include many mythical characters. Over the years, does anybody know what mythical characters would be? Okay, in the next slides we're going to go through some of them.
Scary characters.
We'll believe some of them that you probably never would have thought started in Norway. And over the years, these characters began to show up in stories in other countries and other cultures, and they adapted these. These creatures that I'm going to show you next, these mythical characters, that came from these narratives, they came from narratives of Norway. And and the countries
over.
So let's see. So elves.
No.
Who knows what elves are? Look at those elves. These are magical creatures who lived in the forest.
They're real?
Like Santa's elves?
They're mythical creatures. So mermaids, half women, half fish creatures who often warned the sailors of danger. I've always known what a mermaid was, but I didn't know that they were the ones who warned the sailors of danger.
Real?
Yeah,
they're real.
Trolls.
Those things are creepy.
They say they're big, ugly, hairy creatures that are often dangerous to people, but who are not usually very smart and can easily be outsmarted. Those that lived in the mountains often hoarded gold.
Those are ugly.
And then dwarves, short, human-like creatures who lived underground and were masters of metalworking. So which one of those, I know some of us thought the king was a Viking, but now after seeing those and talking about what they are, what do you think that the king was?
Troll.
Who said troll?
Me.
I think that too.
Yeah, you're right, the king was a troll.
Because look, the guards look like green nasty trolls.
Green nasty things.
Okay. So now we're just going to talk about a couple questions. I just have a couple questions about it, and then we were going to have a snack, but I said it wasn't the lutefisk. I didn't bring that, so what do you think
yeah,
I brought?
Right. Lefse.
Lefse.
Yum,
so everybody's
going
to get to try that.
But
so first we're going to talk about, if anybody had to take a wild guess, how many miles apart do you think that Norway
100.
Is from right where we are?
Oh.
How many miles would you guess?
1,000.
Go ahead.
1,000?
More than 1,000.
Oh,
1,057.
Even farther. Sophia?
I can't think of over. I can't.
Who thinks it's over 2,000?
3,000?
Who thinks it's over 3,000?
I think it's a million.
Okay, so you know how many it is? It's just under 4,000. 3,994.
I thought it was 12,000.
How do you think you could get to Norway? Can we get in our car and drive there right now?
No.
No. What do you think the best way for us to get there would be, though? The fastest?
Walk.
Go ahead. A helicopter. Well, helicopter can get us there fast, but what's kind of like a helicopter that we could get in easily and go on?
Jet.
Walk.
Swim.
Are you a fast swimmer? I'm not that fast.
No.
Ask a shark.
A motorboat.
Are you a mermaid?
Hey, that's a smart idea. But an airplane is probably our best.
Yes,
I'm still saying the
phone.
Okay.
I never did.
Okay. So, who thinks, if you thought about Norway, who thinks that there's, what seasons do we have here? In our country, what seasons do we have? Especially right here in Wisconsin. What do we have in Wisconsin? What? Go ahead.
We have fall, we have summer, we have winter, we have spring, and that's it.
Yeah, good job. So Norway's seasons, a lot of cultures.
The four seasons.
Listen to this, so this is kind of cool. A lot of countries, we as we know, have different seasons, not anything like our. Some are hot all the time, some are cold a lot of the time, some are dark, different. But guess what? Norway's is pretty much just like ours.
Yay!
Their summer is from late June, which usually is when we start to get hot, until the early part of August. And usually then those temps around then are between 77 and 86. So warm enough to go swimming and do that kind of thing.
Yeah, I love going swimming.
And then the fall, their leaves change and are colorful like us. Winter, they have tons and tons of snow. There it's oftentimes below negative 40, which we all know how cold that is. We do not like that. Even negative 0, but think about negative 40 a lot of the time. And then their spring is pretty much identical to ours. Spring, they get the rain, they get the flowers, those kind of things.
Do they have the saying April showers make flowers?
I don't know, but that's
what it
is.
So then the only other thing I have that is helping. Okay, is everybody listening? Because we're going to get to the best part pretty soon. Okay, so the one thing I have before we're going to do the snack that I thought maybe if you have time, a few minutes, you can either do it at home or maybe next week even in class. I don't know if you guys have a few time, but a cool story or a cool project I thought is if you take the mythical, what were the mythical creatures we talked about? Does anybody remember which ones we have? Go ahead.
Elves.
The elves were one. Go ahead.
Mermaids and Vikings.
Mermaids
and Vikings.
Oh,
trolls.
Trolls. And there was one more. Do you remember Elf?
The. Oh.
Yeah.
The ones that lived underground.
Or they didn't know.
Doors.
So a cool thing that I thought would be fun for you guys is if you each take one of those mythical creatures and draw a picture of that mythical creature. And remember kind of what I said each creature was, and tell and write a story that teaches a lesson from that creature. It's a fun project. I know what they even comes up with all her writing, some of us writing you guys do. So that would be a fun project then.
Good idea for next week.
No, not today. You probably won't have time.
No,
but
not today.
Time when you have Mrs. Dan wants or at home or however you want
to
do it.
I want to go at home.
All right. And then we're going to do, let's see here. We're going to do the left side. We're going to see.
Should we go to
your
seat?
Yes, why don't you go to your seat? That would probably
work. Excuse me, this is the
I was just going to say, yep, go ahead. Pass that around. Ella, why don't you start the other one over here? Grab that one out of the thing. Grab the other hand sanitizer, yep. Oh, it doesn't work. Oh, it probably needs to be full. Okay. No. Okay.
So that
you
was
no, we
don't. You set it down there. No, I know you don't. You have to be
for treats. What do we say?
I know, I was just telling Mr. Daniels it was funny because we're at Northern Store, and you can go in any store and they have lefse everywhere.
Right.
Well, here I was going to make it and I couldn't find my griddle and stuff, so I went to Pick and Save. And they
asked the Angelina.
I've never even heard of it. Then I went to Richter's and they're like, don't ask why we have it. We usually don't really have it right now. So, yeah.
Take
a
no.
I
love
colors. You learned about the colors. Did you know that before? That those were the colors?
It's gross.
I didn't know.
Yeah.
Good.
That's what you learned.
I have one
about the creatures. About the creatures? Oh, I thought that part was like,
yeah. Good.
Ellie, you have another one?
Yeah.
What?
About the food.
About the food, yes. Now you know something cool. About so when you're watching Frozen or if you're watching with somebody and they're talking about Norway, you can say, hey, I know this now and different things,
like
right?
I'm
going to do this for you.
I like